On today's episode, Lego abandons recycled plastic project. But why? Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. For decades, plastics engineers working in the injection molding industry acknowledge that one of the global leaders in advanced technology and efficient production is a very familiar Danish company, Lego. The iconic toy has been a staple under Christmas trees for decades, and the relative handful of simple shapes that emulated building bricks have been joined by a stunning array of complex and moving parts. Lego is as much a culture as a toy, and like many European manufacturing concerns, the company is addressing environmental issues. A net zero carbon footprint is promised by 2050, and the company has a realistic action plan to achieve this goal. Now, another angle towards sustainability has been the company's experiments in using recycled resins for its plastic bricks. On June 23rd, Lego announced the development of a breakthrough using recycled PET resin derived from soda bottles. The research effort was considerable, involving a team of 150 testing over 250 different plastic resin compositions. The recycled resin used was sourced from U.S. suppliers and was approved by the FDA and the European Food Safety Authority. A single 1-liter PET soda bottle container, it provided material for about 10 small Lego bricks. But in a surprise move announced on September 25th, Lego is suspending the recycled plastic initiative. From an engineering perspective, the project was a success, producing plastic parts with the necessary durability and physical properties to match Lego's standards. Although an engineering success, the overall carbon footprint of recycling the PET bottles, then reprocessing them into clean, injection mold-ready regular resin, was no better than that of the current petroleum-derived version of thermoplastic. The company announced that it still intends to make Lego bricks from sustainable materials by 2032. The Lego experiment was an engineering success but failed to meet the objective of lowering carbon emissions. While that's a failure in one sense, it represents a sea change in the way environmental issues are handled in the manufacturing of mass production consumer goods. The carbon footprint of recycled products must represent the entire production process. And when shipping, sorting, cleaning, collection and reprocessing are factored into the equation, it's possible that recycling is not only environmentally not sustainable, but it may be a net negative if the oil-derived version of resin is recycled at the end of its lifetime and repurposed into products where the carbon balance is net negative. Lego is an especially demanding user of plastic resin, operating some of the world's most advanced injection molding equipment to produce low-priced consumer goods with consistently outstanding surface finish and dimensional stability. For firms that don't require the quality attributes necessary at Lego, recycled resin may still provide a carbon benefit. In the meantime, Lego is investigating thermoplastics derived from e-methanol instead of crude oil. E-methanol is generated by reacting waste carbon dioxide with hydrogen, which itself can be generated through electrolysis powered by green energy. These e-resins are definitely carbon neutral, but cost remains a concern. Lego is a toy maker, but in the plastic injection molding sector, when they talk, people listen. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, Designing the Future, and the Engineering Roundtable, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.